Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by the CEO of GILD Esports, Jasmine Skee. Jasmine, great to have you on, and some annual results out this morning. Perhaps you'd like to run us through the highlights.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having me, Thomas. We're really proud of the year that we've had. We increased our sponsorship revenue by 168% to $3.2 million, and our overall revenue was up 132% to $4.4. This included naming some big partnerships we were incredibly proud of. The first one being Bitstamp, which was a three-year partnership for $4.5 million that saw them come on as our official cryptocurrency partner. The second partnership that we're incredibly, incredibly proud of is Sky, doing their first ever partnership in esports and one of the biggest partnerships across Europe. So they are now on the front of our shirt, and they're also the naming rights to our HQ that we moved into in June. So it's now referred to as the Sky Guild Gaming Centre. And these also included partnerships with Coke and Hyper Ice, our wellness partner.
That's all understood. Thank you, Jasmine. Now, those results pertain to a period just before you became the CEO. So how are you going to carry on that momentum into 2023?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the momentum. We're doing really well. I think we've got a very, very robust sales pipeline, and I'm looking forward to hopefully announcing some new partners in the next couple of months. I also announced some key hires for us when I came in January. And, you know, my focus is very much delivering operational excellence. And I think these hires really reiterate that. So the first one being Luke Jones. Luke is our director of esports and gaming, and he came from Red Bull, which is one of the biggest gaming brands in the world. So we're really happy to have Luke involved. Today is actually his first day at Guild. We also announced Nick Westwood as our SVP of creative and strategy. So Nick consulted with us last year, but that hire is incredibly important for us. Nick has been at the NBC, he's been at Channel 4, the UFC, and also Gfinity. And that role is really about making sure that we maximize our partnerships that we have on board, our talent strategy, our audience growth, and what content and creative we're doing, as well as he will oversee our esports strategy. And then the final one that I announced was George Morrison. So we really want to learn how to monetize this venue that we've moved into. And Georgia brings some phenomenal experience as she starts as the head of HQ and events. She comes from Gfinity, so great gaming experience, but she's also been at the O2, one of the best venues in the UK, so if not the world. So really happy to have Georgia on board. And then the final thing in Q1 that we're really focusing on, which we announced towards the back end of last year, was Guild College. So in my role here, I'm really passionate about educating, you know, people that want to come into esports, so not just actual players, but people coming in that want to have a career in esports. And so Guild College will play a big part in that for us. We want people to come through Guild and learn through us and either stay at Guild and help professionalize the industry or potentially go into other esports halls.
So working to generate some more income, certainly, but also cutting some costs, Jasmine. What are you doing in that space?
Yeah, I think Guild had a phenomenal 2 years to be one of the most recognized brands in esports in such a short period of time, and we need to recognize that. But as our business evolves, there was a need for cost cutting as well as we move into that next phase of operational excellence. And in the last 3 months, we've managed to bring our costs down by $2.5 million. Which is, you know, we've worked really hard to do that. It's all about right-sizing our business for where we are now and where the future is. Some examples of this included our admin costs, our marketing costs, and also our staff costs, which we re-looked at. And an example of this would include what we did with our influencer strategy. So previously what we were doing, we're working with 10 influencers on a retainer. So we were talking to the same audience kind of week in, week out for 12 months. And what we want to do with this new approach, which helps with the cost, is actually work with talent based on whatever campaign we're trying to achieve at Guild or with our partners or when we're creating content around our own IP. So an example would be last week we worked with Nick Hamilton, who is Lewis Hamilton's brother. And Nick came in and appeared on our Squad Goals show, which is IP that we've created. It's a content series that we've been running. Nick has an audience of nearly 500,000 people. So this approach means that week in, week out, we can choose the right influencers to be working with to help drive our audience growth and help grow the awareness of our brand.
Thanks, Jasmine. So one thing that you have also announced is that you are adapting your content creation strategy. What's the logic there?
Yeah, I mean, further to that example I gave with influencers, Gen Z is a very important primary audience, our target audience for us. And what we did is we looked at where they are, and you have to remember they're a different type of generation. They don't necessarily watch or consume traditional media. They're spending a lot of their time on social media. So when we looked at across the social platforms like Snapchat, TikTok, Instagram Reels, and also YouTube Shorts, what we started to see is, you know, Snapchat and TikTok are vertical video formats, but you can start to see that's also where YouTube and Instagram are going as well. So we did a partnership with Little Dots in November to really have them help us with this strategy that we have. And we're working with them on our vertical video strategy. Since November, we've seen some phenomenal results. Our video views from November are up to 4.5 million, and our channel growth on TikTok alone is up 11%.
All right. Now, you mentioned Nicholas Hamilton earlier there, but one even bigger name that you've got on board at eGuild Sports is David Beckham. So what's he doing for you and what do you get out of it?
David is a fantastic partner and he really believes in our strategy. I definitely don't think we would have brands like Subway, Sky and Samsung on board without David. So we've been so lucky to have him as a co-owner from day one. And if you think about the awareness of Guild, David has definitely played a part in that. He really believes in the sector of esports and he really believes in our vision and the direction that we're going. And along with that cost-cutting exercise that we did, David's actually bought into this vision by no longer taking a minimum payment, but instead he takes a percentage of revenue from what sponsorship and merchandise revenues that we drive. So really helping us with right-sizing the business.
Understood. And just one final question from me, Jasmine. Turning to you personally, you've only been in the hot seat for a very brief time, and you are one of those rare things, which is a female CEO in the world of esports. So what are you bringing to the role and how are you finding it?
I think what I bring to the role firstly is to say, like, we are committed to what we announced at the IPO and that we want to be one of the most successful esports orgs in the world. So I am 100% committed to that. What I want to do personally is really focus on operational excellence. And I think I touched on that with the new hires that I mentioned. I also think audience growth is very, very important for us. And our strategy around what we're doing with influencers, but working with TikTok and Little Dots definitely plays a part of that. Luke coming on board is really to support us from a performance perspective. We're doing incredibly well at the moment in FIFA, in Fortnite. We had a NASC win, the Mr. Beast competition, which was £1 million. And our GILDX girls at the World Championships did an incredible job. So performance is always a big part of what we do. But I'm also incredibly passionate about the brands that we work with and making sure we're delivering a return on them and also creating an ecosystem within Guild that keeps delivering for them but also attracts more partners. And then the final thing I just think is women in gaming. I think if you look at the fact that, you know, in some games, like men can play 180 tournaments last year and women could only play 4. We really want to be the org that provides opportunities for women at a grassroots level and a professional level. We're incredibly committed to that. And I think you'll also see, like, some of our partners, especially Sky, are very committed to that as well. There is definitely an opportunity to work with brands to help with that commitment. It's not just a nice thing to do. There's actually, you know, 40% of the esports market is women, so let's service them. So, you know, in my time in this role, I definitely want to be servicing those women and girls and making sure that they feel that they can have a future in esports.
Very best of luck to you, Jasmine, and thank you very much for joining me today on Proactive.
Thanks, Thomas. Thanks for having me.